I'm going to hack this 9.6 volt Makita and retrofit it to operate on this 12 volt lithium ion battery.
I have two styles of Makita batteries. There's the old style, which was heat welded together, and then there's the new style, which snaps together. This one's going to be far easier to do, but I'll show you how to do both. You want to be careful not to cut into the battery. I need to cut these welds off right here. We don't need this anymore. These two pieces can be discarded. The battery is marked negative and positive. You want to take this little plastic piece and match it up. This tab came out at an angle right here, and this tab was on the end here, meaning that this side is the positive. Okay, these pieces went on like this. So you know that this one is going to be your positive and this side is going to be your negative. I bought a 10 foot long 12 gauge wire, and you need 12 gauge because we need to carry about 10 amps across this wire. We don't need the ground wire. Just need positive and negative. So this piece is going to hold the metal, and then it's going to slide up into here. So there's very little space here for the wires to stick out. My soldering job, as you can see, causes the wires to stick out. I'm just going to cut off this excess tab to make room. All right, now we're going to insert this inside of here. Black is positive. Positive is on this side. We take it, slide it in, take a piece of PVC. We're going to cut this PVC to stay in here as reinforcement. We need to get the right size though. So this end cap has these little tabs on them, and that tab goes into here. So if I take a pen, put a mark here, I need to cut just below that tab. If you cut open an old style battery, you're definitely going to want a piece of PVC. After you do all your soldering and wiring, you're going to take this piece and put it in here, goop it up with a bunch of silicone, slide the bottom on, silicone all of this, make sure that you clean your seam so none is seeping out, then slide the battery inside of a drill that will hold it perfectly and let it set overnight to dry. The wire is going to exit through this side that I cut open earlier, so I need to give this some nice round edges. Now I need to cut off this tab because it's going to be in the way of the wire. We're going to want to take a zip tie and put it on the end here. Then we're going to take our piece of PVC, slide it inside of here. We're going to force the wire in a little bit and bend it. That zip tie is there just in case this wire gets pulled on. It's not going to yank the connection off of here. Then we take our little end cap, snap it back on. Now, we could silicone this on for added protection, but I think it's actually fine just the way that it is. This will now slide into a drill, but we have a problem. It isn't going all the way in because this wire is too thick. So I'm going to have to grind off some of this right here. Okay, now we need to bend this back. Or break it off. Then I need to deburr this right here. Now it's time to work on the other side of the cord that is going to attach to these batteries using these terminals. Don't need green. So I could just take these little tabs here and solder them onto the wire right here. And then these tabs would slide into the battery right here. It would look something like that. But I want to fashion somewhat of a plug to make this work. So I've cut holes into this side that will fit these terminals perfectly. And then I have drilled holes all the way through that will allow these wires to pass through. So now I have something that looks like this. Let's remove the plastic sleeves, slide those down inside of here. Now it looks like this. It's going to go something like this. So these little tabs right here end up needing to go at a slight angle because of the way that they go into here. Now we just work the wires back in. And we end up with something that looks like this. I'm going to put a zip tie back here to hold these wires tight so they don't slide through. All worked out well. There we go. If I'm worried about trying to get it to stay, I can just clamp it like this. That'll make sure that it doesn't fall apart, but it seems pretty tight as is.
And now the moment of truth. Works like a champ. I know you're probably thinking that this is 9.6 volts and this is 12 volts and it's probably going to burn out the motor. And that might be true, but these motors are pretty hardy and these batteries tend to drop from 12 volts down to about 10. So I have a feeling it's going to last a long time. But this was a useless tool prior to me doing this hack here, so I've put it back into service, and if I get a couple of more years out of it before I burn out of the motor, that's not too bad. So if you found this video helpful, really appreciate it if you like it, and of course subscribe for more interesting videos.